Hi students, welcome back to the world of English. Well, today we are going to begin with a new unit which is titled as Art and Culture. Okay, the unit is titled as Art and Culture, and we have reading A, which is titled as The Story of Ikut. Reading B is The Earthen Goblet, and reading C is Maestro with a Mission. Okay, and in today's session we are going to begin it with reading A, that is The Story of Ikut. Okay, let's begin it. Well students, look at the pictures that are shown. Now what do you see in these pictures? Now where do you find them? We see handicrafts, wooden toys made in Kondapalli and Nirmal, beads and pearl necklaces. We also see Ganesha idols. And we see a woman who is, in the attire of Kuchipudi, right? Now, why did the woman decorate herself differently? Now, do you find anything unique in the decoration of the woman in the picture? What could be the occasion for this decoration? Okay, probably she may be decorated herself to perform a dance performance. Okay. She is getting ready for a dance program, right? And she wore attractive ornaments and attire suitable for the performance. Now, what could be, the form of dance she is going to perform? It's a Kuchipudi dance, probably. Okay? Now, are these handicrafts and the decorations a part of our culture? Do you think they are part of our culture? Yes. These handicrafts and decorations are a part of our culture, and these are the articles which enrich our tradition and culture, focusing the reputation of our state all over the world. Okay? Well students, I believe now you might have guessed, right, what reading A is going to deal with. Okay, it's going to deal with the story of Ikut. Okay, let's begin it. Bell rang for the next class. The small break before the next class was enough for the children. They moved around and started chatting. The mandatory 5 minutes was over and the teacher did not come. Okay, now what is the scene? The bell is given, okay, for the next class. Okay, bell rang for the next class. And the small break, okay, the small break before the next class was enough for the children to make all nuisance and noises, it's like how you do it. Okay, so it was sufficient for the children, that 5 minutes of break. Okay, they moved around and they started chatting with the friends. Now the mandatory 5 minutes was over, the break was over, and the teacher did not come. Okay, usually when the time comes for a break, what do you do? The same thing. Okay, so after the 5 minutes, the teacher did not come. The children started wondering, "Ramya, do you think Janaki teacher is absent?" Ramya, looking out of the classroom, said, "How do I know?" A few students were grinning. Everyone knew Ramya loved Janaki teacher who taught them social studies. Okay, it's a clear, right? Now, the mandatory 5 minutes were over, the break was over, the teacher did not come to the class. So, all the children were wondering why Janaki teacher did not come to the class. They thought maybe absent. So, they inquired Ramya. They asked Ramya, "Do you think Janaki teacher is absent?" Because in the class, everyone knew that Ramya likes social studies teacher, that is Janaki teacher. Okay, so they asked her whether Janaki teacher was present or absent. So Ramya, looking out of the classroom, and she said that how she could know. So why? Because see, it's as like you also might be having a teacher whom you really admire, right? The same thing happened for Ramya. Ramya liked Janaki teacher very much, who was teaching social studies, and everybody in the class knew that Janaki teacher was the favorite teacher of Ramya. Clear? Suddenly they noticed the teacher carrying the bundles of clothes walking towards the class. A few of them dashed to help her. They all liked her as she was fair to everyone and was never partial to one student. Okay, so what is next? As they were conversing, suddenly they noticed that the teacher was coming. Which teacher? Social studies teacher Janaki was walking towards the class with the bundles of clothes. Now, when you see a teacher carrying books or you know something, what do? Immediately you attend her, right? The same thing happened for the students. When they saw their social studies teacher carrying bundles of clothes, some of the students dashed to each other and they were running to help out the teacher to carry the bundle of clothes. Okay, now in the class everybody liked Janaki teacher because she was fair to everyone. Okay, she never showed any partiality. She treated everyone equally in the class. That's how she was loved by everyone. Is it clear? The brilliant red and black checked rumals, shawls with the black and blue geometric patterns caught the attention of the class as the teacher handed over the material to the eager helpers. She pinned them neatly on the soft board and the drab class suddenly looked vibrant. Okay, now how were the rumals looking? The rumals were very, you know, with the brilliant red and black color, and the shawls were with the black and blue geometric patterns. Okay, so these were the clothes actually the teacher was carrying to the class. Okay, now when the students saw the teacher carrying the bundle of these clothes, they ran to help the teacher to carry the bundle of clothes, right? Now as the teacher handed over these materials to the helpers, the class became very very attentive. They were very very eager to know what it could be all about. Okay, the drab class, the dull class became more vibrant as the teacher pinned all these clothes neatly and placed these on the board. Okay, simple. The teacher brought the bundle of clothes which made the students to become more vibrant. They became very very active to know what actually the teacher was going to speak about. Clear? Teacher, what are these fabrics? Why did you bring them? Children pelted her with the questions. She smiled and wrote on the blackboard, Textiles of India, Ikat of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so when the teacher brought all these, you know, bundle of clothes, students were confused. So they asked the teacher, what are these fabrics? Now, what is meant by fabric? It's a cloth, right? So the students, you know, pelted, okay, they threw questions after questions to the teacher, what those fabrics were and why the teacher brought those to the class. Okay, the meaning of pelted is throw or shoot. Okay, the students were throwing or shooting questions to the teacher. The teacher just smiled and wrote on the blackboard. Now what did the teacher write on the blackboard? Textiles of India. Textiles of India, Ikat of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so when the students were asking what were those fabrics and why the teacher brought those to the class, the teacher just smiled and wrote on the board, Textiles of India, Ikat of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, no one could spell Ikat, someone yelled Ikat. And a few children giggled. Janaki teacher said, it is pronounced this way. I as I in it, E in it. Ka as ka in Kamala. And T as TH in with. Which means, now identify how it is said. It's Ikat. Okay. So, none of the students could spell it correctly. Okay, someone said Ikat and everyone started giggling, okay, making fun in the class. So the teacher said it is pronounced as, the first letter is I, right? So I is pronounced as E, it, E in it, right? So it's E. K-A as in Kamala, that is Ka. And T as TH in with. Okay, which means Ikat. Okay, it is ikat. Do you understand now? Ikat is an Indonesian term meaning to bind or knot. The class fell silent. Ramya asked, "Teacher, are these fabrics from Indonesia?" Teacher shook her head and said, "Children, can anyone remember seeing designs like this?" So the term ikat is actually an Indonesian term. The meaning of ikat is to bind or knot. Okay, so when the teacher said that the word ikat is an Indonesian word and it is not an Indian word, everyone fell silent, everyone kept quiet. Okay, and immediately Ramya asked, okay, what did Ramya ask? Ramya asked whether those fabrics were from Indonesia, because the teacher said ikat is an Indonesian term, right? So Ramya asked the teacher whether those fabrics came from Indonesia. Okay, so the teacher shook her head. She just shook her head and asked all the children in the class, okay, whether they could remember seeing designs like this. Okay, just looking at the designs, whether they could remember something. Clear? Raghava said, "Teacher, the pattern on the rumal is similar to the one on my mother's sari, though the colors are not the same." Janaki was pleased. Okay, so when the teacher asked the students whether they could remember seeing the designs like this, immediately Raghava says to the teacher that he remembers the design or the patterns on the rumal is very similar to the one that, you know, his mother has. Okay, the sari that his mother owns. Okay, simple. When the teacher asked the students whether they could remember seeing the designs like this, immediately Raghava answers, or you know, he responds that he remembers the patterns on the rumal are very, very similar to the one, the sari that his mother wears. Okay, though the color is not the same, but the designs are same. Clear? She persisted, "Can anyone tell me the name of the place? It is close to our state capital." "There, I gave you a clue." The children started shouting names of all towns in the state. So the teacher asked the students if they can tell the name of the place. Okay, and she also gives the clues that, you know, the clue is that it is very close to our state capital. Okay, that is a clue she gives, right? So the children, they started shouting the names of all towns that they know in the state. Okay, the same thing happens, right? When the teacher asks a question in the class, everyone starts giving their own answers, like you people. Yeah, the same thing happened in the class. In the midst of the babble, someone said Nalgonda, and the teacher said correct. It's Pochampally village in Nalgonda district. Everyone immediately connected to the name. "Teacher, we forgot. We could not link. We all know Pochampally." Okay. So when the teacher asked the students to identify, or you know, if they could remember any place that they could relate to Ikat, the students started, you know, giving different answers. They started giving the names of the towns in the state, okay, and they started shouting in the class, right? So in the midst of the babble, now what is meant by babble? Babble is, you know, it's very a talk, different, difficult to understand, okay, because in the class everyone starts giving answers, right? So the teacher could not identify, but in the midst of the babble someone said Nalgonda and the teacher got the answer. Right, so when the teacher hears that Nalgonda, she says it's right answer, and it is Pochampally village in Nalgonda district. So everyone connects, or everyone immediately connected to the name. Okay, so when the teacher says that it is Pochampally Nalgonda district, everyone, okay, they start, "Oh, we all know," and they say that they have just forgotten and they could not link it. And they all say that they knew Pochampally, they know Pochampally village in Nalgonda district. Okay. Teacher said, Quiet, let me tell you the story of Ikat. It is a story of our handlooms. What are handlooms? Ahmed was the first to voice the question in everyone's mind. So when everyone becomes aware and when everyone connects to Pochampally village, okay, the teacher says, you know, teacher asks the students to sit quietly and she says that she would narrate them the story of Ikat. Okay, and it is a story of handlooms. When the teacher uses the word handlooms, immediately Ahmed raises a question. He voices out. He asks the teacher, what did he ask? What are handlooms? Okay, what did he ask? He asks, what are handlooms? Okay. Teacher gazed around the class and said, a hand-operated loom which weaves and has been weaving fabrics for centuries. In the race against the machine, we have forgotten our heritage. She fell silent and the children recognized her pensive mood and kept silent. Okay, now we are all living in a modern age, right? We are all living in an information and technology age. Okay, everything is happening automatically, right? But in, you know, centuries back, we did not have this much of a technology, and with regard to textiles, it was, you know, everything had to be done by hand. They had to weave. So when Ahmed asks the teacher, what are hand looms? The teacher says that a hand operated loom where they have to use their hands, you know, a hand operated loom which weaves and has been weaving fabrics for centuries. Okay, they have to weave the cloth with the help of hand. Okay, now nowadays it's not so happening. Okay, because we have all modern technology, machinery we have. So we have forgotten our heritage. So the teacher feels really sorry that we have forgotten our heritage and culture. Okay, so she fell silent and all the children, this or the students recognized the teacher was in serious mood. So everybody kept quiet. Okay. Someone asked hesitantly, teacher, you mentioned the story of Ikat. Janaki began, it is called Chitiki in Telugu, Patola in Gujarati, and simply Ikat in Oriya. So actually, what did the teacher say at the beginning? She says that she would narrate the story of Ikat, right? But in between, Ahmed questions, what are handlooms? So she tries to explain what are handlooms and how importance was given for the handlooms at the beginning, okay? And how our handlooms lost their, you know, importance and significance because of the modern technology. Okay, so as she was explaining, immediately one of the student asks, okay, teacher, you said or you mentioned about the story of Ikat. What about it? So Janaki begins to speak about Ikat. Okay, and she says that it is called Chitiki in Telugu. Ikat is Chitiki in Telugu, Patola in Gujarati, and simply Ikat in Oriya. Is it clear? Children's attention was divided between her words and the fabrics as she opened the silk patola sari from Patan, Gujarat. It had a red design on a black background with a rose of flowers in the border. The simple leaf design repeated across the body and the flowers in the border created a mesmerizing effect. Okay, so when the teacher starts narrating about Ikat, she says that it is a Chitiki in Telugu, Patola in Gujarati, and simply Ikat in Oriya. The student's attention was divided between, you know, the words of the teacher, what she was trying to explain, and the fabrics that she brought to the class. So the teacher opened a silk patola sari which was brought from Gujarat. Okay, the teacher opened the sari which was brought from Gujarat. Okay, and how does it look? It, you know, it had a red design on a black background with a rose of flowers in the border, and the simple leaf design which was repeated across the body and the flowers on the border created a kind of mesmerizing effect. Okay, mesmerizing. The meaning of mesmerizing is it's to fascinate, okay, or you know, spellbound. Okay, so it had a mesmerizing effect. Clear? The teacher said, are you thinking about the word ikat or tie and dye while you are looking at the fabrics? What can be the origin of this word? So the teacher asked its students what they were thinking about the word ikat while looking at the fabrics. Okay, just by looking at the clothes, what they thought about the word ikat. Okay, and the teacher asks the students what could be the origin of the word ikat. Is it clear? No one answered but looked expectantly as she continued. In hand weaving, we have threads stretched lengthwise called warp, and threads intersecting with widthwise called weft. Imagine the graph sheet and the x-axis and the y-axis and how they crisscross to form square motifs. Okay, so when the teacher asked the students what could be the origin of the word ikat, no one answered and they were eagerly waiting for the teacher for the answer. Okay, they were eagerly waiting for the teacher to explain about the word ikat. Okay, so the teacher starts explaining. In hand weaving, we have threads stretching lengthwise. Okay, lengthwise it is called warp. And threads are stretching, okay, threads are stretching lengthwise and widthwise. Okay, lengthwise it is called as warp and widthwise it is called as weft. Okay, weft. Now it's like, you know, the teacher gives an example which makes the students to understand better. It is like x-axis and y-axis on the graph sheet and how they intersect to form square motifs. Okay, do you understand? Ahmed was excited. Teacher, warp is stretched along y-axis and weft along x-axis. The class was thrilled as a new understanding came. So the teacher makes, you know, the explanation of the hand weaving, you know, comparing with the graph sheet, that is x-axis and y-axis, how they intersect, you know, the students understand better. Okay, and Ahmed becomes very excited and he tries to explain in his own words. Okay, he says, teacher, warp is stretched along y-axis and weft stretched along with, you know, x-axis. So the class became, you know, more vibrant and they were thrilled to know and to understand the concept. Okay. Janaki said, in ikat, the threads are carefully sorted, warp and weft, divided into bundles, then tied up with the locally available waterproof materials like a plastic sheets, rubber strips from car and bicycle tires, then dropped into color. Okay, so Janaki, the social teacher, tries to explain about ikat. She says, in ikat, the threads are carefully sorted. The threads are carefully arranged in warp and weft. Okay, it's like x-axis and y-axis tight. Okay, they are arranged warp and weft and they divided into bundles. Okay, they are divided into bundles and they are tied with locally available waterproof materials. Okay, what are those waterproof materials? Plastic sheets, rubber strips from car and bicycle tires, and they are dropped into color. Simple. Threads are sorted in warp and weft, divided into different bundles, and they are tied. They are tied with the locally waterproof materials like plastic sheets, rubber strips and from car and bicycle tires, and they are dropped into colors. Simple. Okay, once you untie the knots, you can see white threads dotted with the color at intervals. Ravi said, teacher, How do they know where to tie the knots? Janaki smiled. The ties indicate the design we want. We can look at a design or a motif and a tie. Ravi looked puzzled. It did not seem simple. Ravi, you are absolutely right, the teacher said. It is not easy. So after dropping, you know, the bundles of threads which were knotted and dropped into the color water, then once you untie the knots, once you remove the knots, you can see the white threads with the different, you know, color dots at intervals, okay, alternatively. Okay, so Ravi said, teacher, how will they know where to tie the knots? You remember, they tie the knots to the threads and they drop into the water, right? So Ravi asks the teacher, how will they know where to tie the knot? And Janaki smiled and says, who is Janaki here? Janaki is the social studies teacher. Okay, so Janaki smiles and says, the ties indicate the design they want. Okay, so we can look at the design or a motif and tie. Accordingly, we have to tie the knots. Okay, according to the design we want, we have to tie the knots. And Ravi was completely puzzled. He says, it's not a simple job. It's not a simple job. It's not a simple thing to do. And the teacher says that it is absolutely difficult thing. Okay, the teacher says that it's actually a difficult or tough job. It is not easy. Clear? First, you count the threads, measure the distance, calculate when to repeat a pattern. Only then you can tie the knots. Teacher, it seems like a difficult maths, Ramya said. Correct. Weavers may not be formally educated, but have complex calculations at their fingertips. They draw patterns on the graphs and copy them on the threads. Okay, so when Ravi says, Ravi says that it's actually difficult. Okay, it's actually difficult. It's absolutely difficult. And Janaki madam tries to explain how the weavers do. Okay, what is the first thing they do? First, they count the threads, measure the distance, and they calculate when to repeat a particular pattern. Okay, when to repeat the same pattern, and then only they tie the knots. Okay, so when the teacher was explaining, immediately Ramya interrupts. Okay, she says, teacher, I think it's very difficult like maths. Okay, she says it's you know, the job is like difficult maths. And the teacher says, yes, actually it is difficult, but for weavers it may not be, because weavers may not be formally educated, but they have complex calculations at their fingertips. Okay, simple. When Ramya interrupts, it's like a difficult maths. And Janaki madam says it's absolutely true. And she also explains that weavers may not be formally educated. Okay, they may not have formal educations, but they have a complex calculations at their fingertips. They draw the patterns on the graphs and copy them onto the threads. Clear? Janaki continued, just close your eyes and imagine threads stretched out long with dots of different colors shining. I have seen such a sight in the villages of Nalgonda. Okay, so the teacher asks the students to just close their eyes and imagine the threads that are stretched out with the dots of different colors shining. Okay, and she says that she has seen the sight, that particular sight in the villages of Nalgonda. Okay. Someone said, teacher, the dots are like raindrops, chukka. That is how the name Chitki Rumal. This was a favorite headgear of fishermen and other laborers. It was also the towel on the shoulders of traders in Gujarat. Someone said, teacher, the dots are like raindrops. okay, the dots that are there on the rumal or the cloth, it looks like raindrops. Okay, it calls it as a chupka. Then that is how the name chitki rumal, and that was a favorite headgear of fishermen. Now, have you seen the fishermen when they go for fishing? They tie a rumal over their head, right, or a towel. Yeah, so that was a headgear of fishermen and other laborers, and it was also the towel on the shoulders of traders in Gujarat. They also use in Gujarat. Okay, she suddenly thought of another explanation. She asked, "Children, when you have to measure a small quantity of a material, you use a specific word in Telugu." This time, Ramya answered promptly, "Chitikedu," and before she completed, comprehension was written large on every child's face. So the teacher gets another idea of explaining. Okay, in order to make it little more simple, she asks the students, when they have to measure a small quantity of material, what is the specific word that we use in Telugu? Immediately, this time Ramya, she promptly answers that it is a chitikedu. Okay, and that makes the topic still more simple, and everybody understands. Okay, everybody understands. Teacher, chitiki means small, and small dots of color, which are characteristics of Ikat, the ecotourist. The class was jubilant. They were able to come up with an original explanation for a historical phrase. Okay, so immediately one of the students says, "Teacher, chitiki means small, and small dots of colors which are characteristics of Ikat." Okay, do you understand now? The student is trying to explain, Ikat. Okay, and everyone chorused. Okay, see, sometimes when the teacher asks questions, and when the teacher tries to give the answer, okay, by the time the teacher finishes, you complete, right? The same thing happened. All the students, they just chorused that, small dots of colors are the characteristics of Ikat. Okay, they chorused, they said. And the class was jubilant, the class was completely vibrant. Okay, and they were able to come up with an original explanation of, Ikat, with a historical phrase. They could understand from the historical point of view. Okay, the teacher made them to understand, right? When the trade was vigorous with other nations in Southeast Asia, tie and dye, or chitiki, as lengths of fabric was favorite export item both in silk and cotton. She said, "There are other interesting stories on Ikat. Different regions fight about its origin. Did it travel from Gujarat to the south or vice versa? Did it first originate in the coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh and travel to Nalgonda? There is no systematic historical documentation to resolve this dispute." So when the trade was, at vigorous with other nations in South and East Asia, the tie and dye, or the chitiki, that was, fabric was a favorite export item. Okay, we were exporting. Exporting is sending, right? So exporting silk and cotton. Okay, exporting silk and cotton. And she also says there are other interesting stories about Ikat, and the different regions, fight about its origin. Each one say different different things about the origin of Ikat. Okay, so did it travel from Gujarat to the south or vice versa, which means it went from here to Gujarat, from south to Gujarat, or did it first originate in the coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh and travel to Nalgonda? There is no any systematic historical documentation about the origin of Ikat. Okay. The class was fully attentive now. For Rakshabandhan, the tying of the knot was done by yellow and red ikat dyed threads. Okay. So after listening to the teacher, the students were, you know, they were completely attentive to her to know more about ikat. Okay. And during Rakshabandhan, you all know, right? During Rakshabandhan, we tie Rakshabandhan to brothers, right? So here the Rakshabandhan, the tying of knot was actually done by yellow and red ikat dyed threads. Okay, the threads are dyed with yellow and red color. Okay, in our tradition, tying the knot is sacred. Maybe this has a relation to tying and dyeing process. But in parts of Gujarat, Maharashtra and Deccan, designs in ikat were very much influenced by Muslim culture. Okay, now the teacher says that tying is, you know, considered to be a very very sacred thing in our tradition. Okay, tying is very very sacred thing. Okay, that's what we spoke about previously, Rakshabandhan, right? You are tying for your brother, or tying a knot during marriage. Okay, so the teacher says that in our tradition, in our Indian tradition, tying the knot is considered to be a sacred tradition. Okay, and she also says maybe this has a relation to tying and dyeing. You remember tying the threads and dyeing in the water, right? So she says maybe it is related to ikat, tying and dyeing process. But in the parts of Gujarat, Maharashtra and Deccan, designs in ikat were very much influenced by Muslim culture. Okay, it was very much influenced by Muslim culture in Gujarat, Maharashtra and Deccan. Clear? The bell was ringing, but the class was lost in a period where vibrant colors and compelling stories were woven into beautiful fabrics. Okay, so finally the period comes to an end, but still the students were lost in the memories and compelling stories of ikat. Okay, compelling stories of ikat. Okay, I believe you have understood, right? Well students, here is a small video clipping. You can just watch it and you will understand much better. Okay, a video on how ikat is made by a man. Okay, clear? Well students, I believe we have understood. Here is a small video clipping of how ikat is made. Okay, here you will see in the video how a family is involved in a traditional way of making textiles or making, you know, ikat. Okay, let's watch it. Fine students, I believe you have understood today's session, right? See you in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye.